Okay, I'm gonna go for an arena run here. Let's go for a rogue. Demolisher, Gajasong, Young Priestess. Gajasong's good if I end up getting a lot of spell par stuff. Demolisher's good kind of either way, but it's a support card. This is still a 4-4 for 5, which isn't terrible. So, here we go, Gajasong. Tricky choice, but Deadly Poison's always useful. Venture Co., Gnomish Inventor, Iron Big Isle. Don't like the Isle. Inventor's very good. Venture Co.'s very good. We already have 1-5 cost. I think I'd rather get a harder hitting 4 though. Assassinate Vanish, Stormpike Commando. Already 2-5s in the deck. It's tricky. I'd say this dies too easily. I'm gonna go Assassinate. Viscerate, Fan Creeper again. I'm filling up in 5s far too much. Really good card, but I'm gonna go for Viscerate. Cold Blood, Vanish, and Sprint. Cold Blood. Sometimes good. Shieldmaster, Ghoul. Let's say Shieldmaster's probably better in general. Ghoul's a little situational. Silverhand Knight's always good, but I have so many 5s. I'm only 7 cards in. Shouldn't be a problem, but no more 5s from now on. Brewmaster, got Tazdingo on 4 already. I think I'll take another Deadly Poison. Abomination's a good 5, too many 5s, Young Priestess, Imp Master. Jesus. This dies too easily as a taunt, this doesn't hit hard enough. And I can't buff it. Buff it with Cold Blood, I suppose. I could get a 5-7 for 5, in theory, if it comes out right in the combo. And I need to combo into that. That's far too situational. Acidic Swamp Ooze, yes, I need 2 drops badly. I have far too many 5s. I have far too many 5s. Stop this. I'm actually gonna go Abusive Sergeant. Stormwind Champion's good. Yeah, that'll do. Seriously? Okay. Think I'm actually gonna go with the Tidehunter here. Yeah. I have a good mid game, you know, if I can get there. I'll take the Infiltrator. Master Disguise, Blade Master, Blade Flurry. Master Disguise is good. Blade Master, there was. It's gonna be a 4-3 for 3. This is a 4-4 for 4. I don't think there's anything that I really want to stealth. Imp Master, possibly. Just so I can keep spawning imps. Meh. Go with the Blade Master. Yeah, Brewmaster, definitely. Zap can be sort of situationally useful, but you know, a lot of the time they're just going to end up playing the card again. You don't get any card advantage from it, you lose card advantage. Like, it's always a 0 for 1. I have enough mid late game stuff. Need 2 drops really badly, so I'll take a Lid Hoarder. So see, deck hand's not terrible in a rogue deck, because it pretty much will always come out with charge, or you play it in turn 1. And, you know, it's 2-1 trades with a 2-drop a lot of the time. But I think Razor Fen's probably better. I don't have a huge amount of 3s, so... Fairy Dragon, definitely. Need those 2s. Another Deadly Poison. Yeah, why not? Because, you know, if I can get to this sort of mid-late game with the removal, it won't be that bad. Fairy Dragon. Because mid-game's fine. I'll be looking to get the kill then, turn 5 to 7, the looks of things. Which, this could be good for. Cult Master with the Imp Master could be pretty good. Get the card draw. Silvermoon Guardian's pretty good. Rocketeer could be good in this deck because I'm looking for those early kills and just, you know, the last 5 damage. I'd say Silvermoon Guardian's probably the most consistent. I'll go with that. I mean, what have I got 2 drops wise? Acidic Swamp Boost, 2 Fairy Dragons, 3, 4, 5 now. That's not bad. I'll take another Deadly Poison. 4 Deadly Poisons. This is excellent. Earthen Ring, maybe? Map Armor's good, but we're actually kind of good on 2 drops now. Earthen Ring is going to heal up what? Me, probably. From all the Deadly Poison knife attacks. Yeah, why not? I'll go with the stats and take the Azure Drake. So this is an odd deck. I don't think it's going to do that well. There's none of the really good stuff in it at all. It's got a strong sort of mid to late game. If I can get there. A lot of deadly poisons to help me get there. And I could stack them all up. Was it plus 2 damage in each one? I have 4 of them. So for 4 mana I can get like a 9 attack knife. That's a pretty good hand to start off with anyway. I think I'll keep that. Probably coin into Silvermoon on 3. Hopefully I'll have a 3 drop. By that time anyway, so I might not need to.
The pleasure is mine.
It's just polite to say hello, isn't it? Yep, there's a 3 drop. Yeah, Worgen, I think. And I can make it a 4-1 for a turn if I want. If he plays a Northshire Cleric, that's definitely going to be the play. He did not. I don't want to reveal that. Do I want card draw, or... what's he going to use? Shadowward Death? Or Shadowward Pain? It's probably his only direct removal. I don't think he can really do 1 damage without like an Elven Archer or something like that, so... I'll probably survive okay. I probably could have attacked with the Worgen, but
I am not a morning person.
Well, I'm not sure about that. Yeah, I can definitely maybe a Sergeant the Lead Order. 4-1, Trevor the 1-4. And I think we'll just knife and get rid of that. It's probably fine to attack with that now. I have 2 2-1s anyway, I don't think he's gonna get rid of both of them. It'd be a huge waste of a Holy Nova, that would actually be good for me.
Tandingo!
Yes. Get the taunt out. Can I buff anything? I do have the damage to kill it on the board, and then play either my own taunt or Silvermoon. Or get another knife out and do Fairy Dragon.
Um
Here I'm pretty much go. Definitely going to be trading. It's just a question of whether I want to play this or this. I'll go with this. Shall not fall. I don't really think there's going to be much advantage in having a taunt out at the moment. He doesn't have anything on the board. I'm not protecting anything. It's fine. It's 3-3 for 4-4 anyway. Unless he does that. 4-5, I'd need to do 2 damage. So, probably... Tustengo. Or I could do Gadgetson Auctioneer. Nah, that's a waste of the coin. I can do that next turn though, and then coin out Fairy Dragon. Remember, kill for us. So we'll take 3 there, and then I can trade it out. And he gets a 2-for-1 on the Spellbreaker. And oh no, it's 2-for-2. Yeah, that's not enough. I can still kill that. And I don't actually need to use a minion to do it. Yeah.
My eyes are open.
Here
so
we go.
Get rid of that.
Remember, kill the lust.
You can't kill the Earthen Ring with this. So that's all good. I'm still just sort of struggling for board control at the moment, but life's reasonably equal.
I hope you like my
I have 5 cards, he has 7 now. And I don't have a taunt to bother with this.
Of course.
That trades with that pretty handily and survives a little 2-for-1 with the novice inventor, probably. Let me see. Gadgetson coin would be 3. There's still no combo there to have. Some of the 5.
I wonder.
No, the most damage I can put out really is a 4. I don't want to put that out because he'll just kill it instantly. We'll clear the board. Even then, he could have Shadow Word Death or something. Actually,
here we go.
Yeah. I'd rather he didn't kill that quite so easily. I'll do this with a card draw. There's another deadly poison. Let's throw this out. Sort of one way or another gives us a means to kill the tiger once he gets it out of stealth. Well, he's going for the face and giving us pretty favorable trades off the back of that, and I just pulled an assassinate.
Of course.
Which. What do I use the assassinate on then? That leaves me 3 mana. So, taking 10 could be a problem, but I don't want to lose 2 creatures.
Here we go.
Take me down to 10, rather. So, get that board advantage. Now, Stormwind Champion. He has card advantage now.
Don't mess with Tusk.
That's annoying. Draw a card. Doesn't help at the moment. Let's get stuff out on the board.
Ready, sir.
And kill that.
Job done.
You can trade it out for the boar, but still two for one and a half, I guess. And am I dead? No, I'm not dead. I could brew that back and play it again, but I think I really need to get stuff off the board. I can play that.
Behold the might of Stormwind.
And then I don't lose this when I do that.
Here we go.
Job done.
So I'm in it for 11, which brings him down to 10. In other words, he's dead in two turns unless he does something. So hopefully that'll take his attention away from hitting my face. But I only have 8 left, so the easiest way for him to win is pretty much to just kill me outright. That's odd. Oh, that makes sense. So I do need to keep killing, clearing his board. I can't let him hit me, like, even once. I have no other way of doing 4 damage. It'd be nice if I could hit with that and then brew it back and play it again, but I can't.
To battle.
So it's gonna have to be that.
Death again.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
And all of that, apart from... No, yeah, this all survives Holy Nova. So if I got 9 plus 7, 16, and 4 is 20
here
on the board. It's trying to work out if it was right to hit him, but it's always right to hit him because you can just use the hero part again. Oh, god damn it. I think I actually need to do that for the 3 damage, otherwise they're just gonna wipe out my whole board.
Here we go.
I do need to kill both. That dies.
Push forward.
And that dies.
Well played.
Mind blast? Oh, holy fire. Okay. Okay. That's sad. So we're 0-1 at the start. But you're never really sure in the first game how strong the opponent's going to be, and if you lose they get weaker, apparently. Not so far. So maybe we can win this one.
Valera versus Uther.
Paladin.
I will fight with honor.
What?
Hard to know, really. But they got a lot of buffs that can be really hard to deal with. Don't need 5 cost minions at this stage. Deadly poisons is good to have. Well, you can only really play it in turn 3. So have a turn 3, 4, and 5 play.
Well met.
Nothing until then.
The pleasure is mine.
Well, he doesn't have much either. It's probably safe enough to hit once, but if I'm gonna deadly poison next turn, then I still don't have a 3-drop. And don't want to play Viscerate. That's no, because I'd need to overkill the board to play it. Basically what I'll do is hit with this, and then eviscerate this, and clear the board. But I don't mind leaving the 1-1 alive. It would essentially be burning an eviscerate on a 1-1. And if he coined into his 3-drop, does he have another 3-drop to play?
Reporting for duty.
No, he doesn't. That's good. I have a Silverman Guardian to play.
Shall not fall.
It still trades well for all that. I could hit him for 3 and bring the health equal. I think it's better off killing a minion, because something like a Spellbreaker could be played on 4.
You call that
Barbarian Dwarf. God damn. Well, I can eviscerate it. Four, he'll kill that, and the board clear will actually damage me because I'm at lower health. He'll still kill this, but I get a card draw out of it.
Not on my watch.
Well, that's annoying.
Reporting for duty.
That could be a problem for him. Might clear part of the board. Secrets. Oh, good. See, that's the thing. You could just play Humility or something. I think that's one of the secrets, isn't it? Or just the health of a summoned minion to 1.
What we do.
And there's no point in buffing its attack. It clears the board anyway, so I don't want to waste the charge on my dagger. In theory, this should kill everything he has. Depending on what he does. He might trade it out anyway, because I probably missed 4 damage there, really. I would have traded it next turn. Unless, no, I would have eviscerated. Don't want to eviscerate that. I have absolutely no board clear of nothing at all that hits multiple minions. So I just need to give him problems.
Squire, attend me!
Ready, sir.
No, is anything here worth eviscerating?
Here we go.
Yep.
Get down!
Seems about right. God. We can trade that for that, and then those 2 for those. So. If I eviscerate this, then he can't clear the board with what he has unless he has a True Silver / Consecrate, whatever. So 6 health on the board, and he has 5 damage on the board. So 1 extra damage on the board will clear it, but it's pretty much the best I can do. He has 8 cards, I have 8 cards. 2 of those 8 cards are pretty decent minions. Blessing of Kings, yeah, there we go. So that actually pretty much overkills that. Not the holy light? Huh. If he's focusing all this just on what he has on the board, maybe his hand isn't all that good. So.
You've gotta be kidding me!
Trades out both of those for that. Then I can play the other one in cold blooded later if I need to.
The gates are open.
That's not good. But he's going for me, which is good.
How you doing?
Because that trade's over. Let's get rid of that. Play that because that trades with the board.
Here we go.
It doesn't trade with the board. And I can still do Ventricle Merc Cold Blood. That's only 5 damage. That's 7. That will kill it. Can't trade anything for that. I can kill that with on anything, I should say. So let's just. He only has 1 card left. He would need to throw everything at this to kill it.
You've gotta be kidding me!
And we don't even need to buff it yet, because if he does trade out. And it's actually worth. Because that'd be 4. He needs to use the tiger, and he'll lose the tiger. That's the main thing here. I'm kind of tempted to throw the Uzi just because it trades well, but I'm sure he probably has weapons in his deck. If he goes for me, actually, he could do. That's 9, gets me down to 4, that's kind of okay. No. I'll wait and see if he plays a weapon. Well, okay, that works. Now I can get him to 2.
Reporting for duty.
And as I previously said, I have no means to attack the entire board. GG. Okay, we are kind of unsurprisingly 0-2. Just 1 win. That'd be nice. It was a pretty awful draft, though.
Valir versus Garrosh.
Victory or death.
Watch your.
No, maybe. Don't want that. I do have a lot of 2s in the deck. I wonder, should I just ditch that and hope to get one? No, because it could easily come with 5/5/5 as well. Then I would be in trouble.
The pleasure is mine.
No play. Throw it a lit hoarder. Does he have a 2 drop? Does it have 2 health? He does not. Good. So I can develop the board a little bit.
Hey, give me that!
Knife, deadly poison. Should get 3 out, so we place 3 and just kill it instantly, but I can do that anyway, so... There's a fan hunter. So I got a nice little board here. Whirlwind will take me down just having a 2-2, but... Kinda get value out of these anyway. It's not a great solution. Coin, 2 mana. Armor up. He blew the coin on armor up. Oh, okay. I don't know if I even really got any spells for the Gadgetzon. I think that counts. I've got a lot of those. It's a pretty decent trade. But I can just do this next turn. Which is only for me. It's worth 1.5. Gadgetzon or I think we'll get the Ventricomash scenario, but this is shown that he doesn't really have many things to deal with the board. Unless it's just all full of amazing 5 plus drops. Then like a Cruel Taskmaster I think would have been played earlier to kill the Lit Hoarder. So that combo with X-Kit isn't likely to be coming. It's probably not a great move, buddy. Can't afford that.
Hey, give me-
Get a Bishop Sergeant. Maybe she'll just do this. And there's no need to attack right now. Can Brewmaster next go around? Uses up all my mana though. So I basically swap out a Lit Hoarder for Brewmaster. Much, you know. Swapping out a 5-4. Another shield block. Do you have a shield slam? Magma Rager. Yep.
Hey, give me that!
I can't do that.
Really? Yeah, you can. What's that, 13? Then be 9 plus 5, 14 next turn. Yeah, okay.
Here we go.
So he's dead unless he puts up a taunt or kills one of these. In fact, he's dead even if he does put up a taunt. Play one big minion. Thank you. Don't have a whirlwind either, please. Yes.
Well played.
Here we go. Yay, we won one. 3-1 the dream. I have not been keeping my win losses bar up to date. It's fixed now.
Valera versus Gul'dan.
This could be interesting.
Your soul shall be mine.
Watch your back.
This is kind of the thing. If he wants to just Zerg me down, he totally can. There's not much I can do about that. I have so many fives in the deck, I'm like worried about getting rid of that. Hey! 1, 2, 3, 4. Perfect.
The pleasure is mine.
I greet you, Swell Blood.
If it plays a Flame End here, it's a 1-for-1. But it's good because Flame End actually has better stats and damages him. So it's basically like hitting him for 3. Does anyone still run Mortal Coil? Because they want to get in the card draw, if they do. But I kind of feel like doing damage to him early is going to be a little important. I'm gonna risk it. Or not risk it. I'm not sure which is riskier. Yeah. Haven't seen you in a while. He wouldn't have played Mortal Coil there if he had it, I suppose, but
first.
That's been hanging around long enough, just can combo into Eviscerate and do another 4 damage to him, but I think I'll save it for minions. This 4 damage at this stage doesn't make a huge amount of difference. No. Can't do that. But I'm assuming that was Mortal Coil, so yeah, okay, he did have it. Oh well. No. Where's the flavor text? Dude.
I wonder.
We're all learning, but you know. There you go. That works. And I think we play Divine Shield. What the hell was he trying to target that with? Because if he has a drain life or something, he can pop the shield and trade it out. For 5 mana, which gives him 3 mana to play something.
So many options.
But I don't really see a better way of dealing with it.
Shall not fall.
That's a drain life demon fire or something like that. I guess it's still a 2-for-1. Oh, thank you. Huh. Well, he did use up a lot of cards doing that. Which gives me a 2 card advantage on him. Turn 5. What have I got for turn 5? Just 3 drops. Probably.
Here we go.
Do that.
Murder!
Do that. so I can maintain my card advantage.
So many possibilities.
Yeah, it's starting to get to the point where I should have drawn more fives by now. He's just whittling down his cards and getting rid of his direct removal. Good double deadly poison. Yeah. I do have four of them.
Here we go.
Razor Fan.
Don't mess with us.
Coin in the Eviscerate. Stop him life tapping. Or make it more risky for him to life tap. Like, I'm pretty sure I wasn't gonna end up using Eviscerate on him anyway. And I should be drawing into more 5 cost heavy hitting minions at this point. So hopefully I won't regret that, and hopefully I didn't just lose the game right there. I do have 8 damage on the board.
Tazdingo! Yes.
I think I'll assassinate that one. There we go, 5 drops. Did I get rid of that? You can't buff it.
Sucks!
I'm gonna assume he's going to trade. And I don't really care if he doesn't. He can't. Well, it's still just a 1-for-1. Now, if he hits that, then I can kill it with a knife and keep the hunter alive.
Mind if I roll knee?
What kills that? Hey, he traded. Okay. 7 health left. Ooh, did I? No.
Squire, attend me.
Ready, sir.
I can do 5. Is it worth doing 5, 6? If he buffs it, Parvelwhelming. He would need to have really specific cards. I think I'm just gonna go for it.
Here we go.
Job done.
He's dead next turn unless he kills both of these. He only has 1 creature on the board. Not to say he's not gonna have direct removal, but then it's 2 knife stabs and he's dead anyway. I don't think he can kill me in 2 turns. A double par overwhelming demon fire or some such thing. No, that's not what he has. Summoning portal's kind of useless at this point. Hasn't got a lot of shit out. What's your last card? Better be a good one.
You love my new recipe.
It ain't. GG.
Well played.
Well played.
Okay, well, pretty bad start, but we're 2-2 at the moment. 3-3 wouldn't be bad with this deck, because it's all 5 cost minions.
Valera versus Valera.
What?
This could be tricky if they have like backstabs and stuff.
I will be your death.
Coin into one of these on turn 2. Play this turn 4. Yeah. Or just play this turn 2, play one of these turn 3. We'll see. It's decent, and it gives me options. Many options.
It's time for a little blood.
So there's only three attack. Shit. No, that's fine. I was saying I was coining into a three cost, and like he can enrage off any of them. Drawn into an eviscerate at this point might have been okay, but let's see, no eviscerate. Can't take that out, but it takes a whole board to do it. Might be worth it. And then it just comes back. Or I could wait and play the abomination next turn. I could play the abomination this turn. Kills my board. May also kill his board. We'll see what he does. That works.
I am not a money person.
Let's get stuff on the board. Gonna get pretty good trades on everything. I can ignore it, and then I can use my weapon to get through that, actually. It's not too bad. Okay.
Here we go.
Which also means I can trade the crop stuff. And we're sort of stabilized, but I'm way down in health. It's looking very much like a 2-3 run. Two damage, the only thing. It's just he can trade quite well. Sorry, pup. Okay.
I wonder.
Okay. Play that anyway.
Oh, this.
I think we need to risk hitting him. Would I need to bring a soul stone? Or, well...
Here we go.
Clear the board. Board control more important. It's running a little low on cards. Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta be kidding me!
First kill.
Here we go.
That was dumb. There was no reason to take that damage there.
Job's done.
I took the damage to get a 1-1 on the board. That was just stupid. Because he could easily just combo an Eviscerate into me and... Or Bluegill, or... no.
Well played.
Well, he's assuming there's nothing I can do.
How you doing?
Well played.
There's nothing I can do.
I
will be your death. I will be your death.
Yeah, 2-3. I'm not really sure there's much you could have done differently there. Rogues can be amazing in arena, but I don't know, if you don't get the right spells and stuff. Oh well. We had fun anyway. See ya.